Through there. Having not heard from Lopez. This seems to represent Unuratu. The smell. This must be the place Etsli mentioned. Steady, Lara, steady. Smell. This must be the place Etsli mentioned. Steady, Lara, steady. I'm gonna be sick. Okay, take it slow. You can do this. Ritual sacrifice. great. I guess I have no choice. Is this one of the rebels? There's a way in somewhere. A serpent with a silver eye. I'm on track. Yes, through there. The smell keeps getting stronger.
Laura, how's it going?
I found another serpent with a silver eye. I must be getting close. You?
Talking tattoos with Uchu.
Tattoos?
Yeah, you saw Unuratu's, right? It has a heron and an eclipse on it. That might have something to do with the silver box.
I don't think so. To burn that barrier. Be a way to burn away that barrier. The lone figure appears in a state of peace as full of oil. Blood. That barrier's down. Need to keep moving. Is this some kind of bloodletting chamber? Barrier. Must have taken hundreds of sacrifices to get enough blood to fill these channels. Be a way to turn the second wheel. Must be a way to turn the second wheel. Thank you. too heavy. Needs more torque. Be a way to turn the second wheel. Now, to find the silver box. This must be what Trinity's missing.
There's the little rebel prince.
Esli!
Over there! Get her!
Magandhi. How would you make Magandhi?
To ask you. I think it's a favor.
Okay, I'll make my way back as soon as I can. I don't have enough space for that. Unuratu must be worried about Etsli. I have to tell her he's been captured. Unuratu! Hetzli's been captured.
I know. They're holding him at the barracks. We're working on a plan to release him.
I tried to get him, I'm sorry.
He's a warrior. What's that? This is a key. It looks like it belonged to the mountain temple. It is adjacent to where they're holding him. Is the box of HL connected to the barracks? Is that why the cult occupy the temple? It's heavily guarded. When we go in, it has to be subtle, silent.
Is there a back way?
There was one, by the salt mine, but it has deteriorated. It's treacherous.
I might be able to manage it.
Perhaps. You did survive the sacrificial pit. I haven't been back inside since I was a child. But from what I can remember, the barracks are within an inner stronghold.
If I can get in through the back way, I can clear a path and let you in. We will free Etsli, then go find the box.
I'll take care of myself. You go after the box.
I don't know. We're trying to keep a low profile.
I would go. Only I can't abandon my post here. Time is running short. It would mean a lot to Queen Unuratu and the rebellion.
29th of November.
Hey, Lara. Do you have a minute? Come over if you have time. Uchu has something to ask you. Uchu and I were talking, and, well...
Uchu, what's on your mind?
The day of Edsley's coronation is approaching. Soon he will be a man and take the first steps towards becoming Paititi's future king.
That sounds like a day to look forward to.
It's the hope for that day that keeps a lot of us fighting Amaru and his cult.
Sometimes we all need to remember what we're fighting for. Is there something I can help you with?
When Esli's father, Sairi, died, Unuratu bestowed the honor of surrogate father onto me. One of my duties is to gather 3 sacred items for the ceremony. But...
with all that's happening right now, you aren't able to. What are these items?
They are the Savior's amulet, the champion's bow, and the king's horn. Each a blessing from the ancestors of the future king.
Tell me what you need, and I'll see what I can do.
I already have men retrieving the amulet and bow, but if you could find Kabil, the instrument maker, and get the king's horn from him, you would be doing us a great favor. He's been difficult. I sent 2 men and both have failed. Perhaps you could talk to his wife.
I think I can manage that.
Be mindful. Kabil can be prickly sometimes, but Abra, his wife, has a way of dulling his edges.
What are we doing here? I never wanted this to happen, now...
Abigail is too busy for these wild goose chases, Vancho. She's not a child anymore. She has a town to take care of.
Aye, you just don't want her chasing ghosts.
I love old maps. When I was a little girl, they always led to treasure.
They always make me feel more lost.
My name's Lara, by the way.
Pilar. You don't look like the type of tourists we usually get.
I'm an archaeologist, actually.
Yes, that would be more fitting, I think. You should speak with Abigail. She knows the history of this place better than almost anyone.
We've already met. Abby's been kind enough to let my friend and I stay with her while we're visiting.
Ah. Well then, you are a welcomed guest in Kuakyaku.
Thank you. Do you need help understanding the map?
It wasn't meant for me to understand.
I have hidden the truth, as Abigail will find, but to uncover it, she must take a trip back in time.
Mariana was never much of a poet.
Mariana?
Abigail's grandmother. We lost her to cancer 1 year ago today, actually.
I'm sorry to hear that.
Mariana wanted Abigail to have the map on the anniversary of her death, but...
You're not sure?
I don't know if she's ready.
It's none of my business, but if it helps, Mariana believes she was.
You're right. I guess it never was my decision, was it? Would you mind delivering the map to Abigail? You could make a full-time job of chasing that girl around, and my hips just won't have it.
Not at all. Abby's grandmother wanted her to have this, but why? Pilar didn't seem to know. It has to have something to do with the riddle she wrote on the back. I have hidden the truth, as Abigail will find, but to uncover it, she must take a trip back in time. Abby. It's Lara.
Hey, stranger. How are you making out? How's Jonah?
Jonah's fine. He's with a friend.
A friend, huh?
Sí.
What's her name?
His name is Uchu. Listen, Abby, I'm back in Kuakyaku, and I've come across an old map that belonged to your grandmother.
Well, there's an old-timer in town, Diego. He runs the community garden. He's into maps, I think. Maybe he can take a look. Meet me there?
On my way.
Help you?
I'm a friend of Abby's. She asked me to meet her here. We have a map we'd like you to look at.
Oh, let's have a look. This is a nice piece of work. Good detail. Happy to see it's held up all these years.
You're familiar with it.
Might be a little more dust in the attic these days, but I never forget my work. Abby's grandmother asked me to draw it up. If I remember right, it was supposed to be some kind of gift for Abby.
There are blemishes here, three of them, do you see?
Hmm. I didn't put those there. It smells like lemon, doesn't it?
Lemon?
Lemon juice can be used as ink to... There could be a heat-fix message hidden in the map. Can I use your brazier?
Sure. Be my guest. So how does this work?
Well, lemon juice is organic, so it will oxidize and turn brown when it's heated, and a secret message will appear.
It's been a lot of years. You think it'll still show?
As soon as Abby gets here, we're gonna find out.
Find out what?
Speak of the devil.
I'm an angel, Diego. You know that.
Not when you were little.
Abby, according to Diego, your grandmother asked him to make the map for you, as a gift.
Why would I need a map of the village? I know this place in my sleep.
There's more. Your grandmother hid something here in the paper. You can barely see it. I think it's a secret message.
She used invisible ink.
Invisible ink? Really?
Well, it's just lemon juice, but...
But it does the trick.
So, what's this secret?
Don't know. May I?
Let's take a look.
Look, those symbols, they're...
Three X's.
X marks the spot.
Cute, Grandma.
Are these points far from here?
Nope. Should we split up?
Sure. I'll take those two there. Thanks. Abby's grandmother, Mariana, used lemon juice as invisible ink to hide three small X's, like a classic treasure map. There's a three-stepped edge on one side that looks to have been carved by hand. Interesting. The other edge is roughly broken, like it's been shattered. This is only a piece of something larger.
Mm-hmm.
Abby, how are you making out?
Almost at it. Whatever it is. You?
Look for a fragment of stone with a three-stepped edge. I found one here. I'm sure we're looking for two others.
You're the expert.
Abby, how are you making out?
Almost at it. Whatever it is. You?
Look for a fragment of stone with a...
You're the expert.
Shit! Abby, how are you making out?
Almost at it. Whatever it is. You?
Look for a fragment of stone with a three-stepped edge. I found one here. I'm sure we're looking for two others.
You're the expert.
Full up. Can't carry anymore. This describes something nearby. I lie silent where arrows once flew, guarding a door which will no longer open. Hand carved on one side. Broken on the other. Definitely part of something larger. It's almost familiar, but I wonder.
Lara, I think I have one of those stone things here.
I've got the others.
Now what?
Now we put them together and see what your grandmother is trying to tell you.
Pilar understood Grandma better than anyone. Meet me at her place.
Impossible. I can't carry any more. The walls are porous. The oil must be seeping through. When the caverns begin to howl. The elders of the village have like Votan is an ancient mine. This is the way to exit the tomb. Sholot, god of death. I'll have to get over there. I'll have to put that fire out. There's my way across. Need to get to that ledge. There's my way across. Need to get to that ledge. I'll have to time this right. To extinguish the fire. There's a blockage on the other side. I'll need more power. Find a way to destroy it. I'll need more power. Something's holding it in place. There must be a way to unblock the shutters. A way to unblock the shutters. Almost there. Be a way to unblock the shutters. Now to get that other pendulum moving. Almost there. Time to get out of here. Impossible. I can't carry anymore. All full up. Can't carry any more.
Creo que es hora de que hablemos.
I was hoping Abigail would be with you.
She's on her way.
Hi, Auntie.
It's been too long, child. Oh, let me look at you. Still with the short hair, I see.
Auntie, we found something in Grandma's map.
Actually, your hair could be better too, now that I see you again. The pair of you are like tomboys out chasing after.
Auntie, please. Why did Grandma want me to have the map? I deserve to know.
Do you remember the stories your grandmother used to tell you as a child? About a magical, hidden place built by your ancestors?
Yes, but I grew up, and she grew old, and nothing magical ever happened.
But she didn't forget her promise. It's there, in your hands.
Why now?
I'm only the custodian of the map. It's up to you to discover its purpose.
Abby, I'm sure whatever is revealed in this map will lead to that hidden place and your answers.
I hope so. All right, let's take a look.
If we place each one of the fragments on the map where they were found, like so...
That's the Chacana, the Inca cross. It represents the three levels of existence. The upper world, the middle world, our world, and the underworld.
It also represents the things that make us human. Like the ability to love, to take action, to gain wisdom.
But if I'm remembering correctly, the center of the Chacana is said to represent Cusco, the capital of the Inca Empire. In the context of the map, we're hundreds of miles from there.
Well, there are many interpretations of the Chacana. Cusco, a portal from one world to the next. It is also said to be the Eye of God, a guardian keeping watch over us all.
So, what are we looking for? I mean, this has to point to something, right?
Let's take a closer look. There has to be something we're not seeing. Something... There! I thought it was a small blemish when I first saw it, but in this light, it looks like a Maya hieroglyph.
Maya? That doesn't make any sense. We are Inca. What does it say?
Hahil. It means truth.
Truth? Truth about what?
I don't know. Does this place on the map mean anything to you?
Grandma and I would sit there when she told me stories about the hidden place.
Perhaps you'll find your answers there.
Are you ready?
Keep the map. I'll meet you there.
I thought the pieces looked familiar. It's not until I put them all together that I can see it. It's the Chacana. The Inca cross. There are many interpretations. There. I thought it was a small blemish when I first looked at it, but in this light, it looks like a Maya hieroglyph. It means truth. strong to be amber. It may be copal. It smells wonderful. This is a little bit unusual. Impossible. I can't carry anymore. This is a promotional model of an oil derrick made out of cheap plastic and copper. There is a logo for a company called Poor Veneer on the base of it.
Watch out for Abigail, please. Keep her safe. We can't lose her.
Sí, el nivel de mercurio.
I've got some stuff to trade if you're looking.
Hi, hello.
I think I can help you. A good deal for both of us. Excellent choice. Enjoy. A good deal for both of us. Excellent choice. A good deal for both of us. Pleasure doing business with you. Do you have anything you want to trade?
Ugh.